Hey, you're watching with Wendy. Today I'm going to show you guys how I made a Mansur Gavriel bucket bag. I'm not 100% on whether or not I'm pronouncing this correctly, so please forgive me if I'm not. I would try to practice, but perhaps there would be no improvement. How far out have I got to move? Oh, I gotta get next to you. But you're so far away, searching for a heart another. If you're familiar with the leather bag market, this bag has been sold out for quite a while. Every time they restock, it sells out in like, I don't know, 5 minutes. I haven't personally been trying to keep track of it, but I have friends who have tried every time to get one. To no avail, it comes in tons of beautiful colors, black, red, camel, ballerina, pink, gray, blue, silver. I decided to make mine a gray color just because it's a bit more versatile and easy to match with. And yes, it's my first time trying to make a leather bag. Normally with leather, you should be buying leather tools, leather materials. I didn't feel ready to fully invest in those things yet. So I tried my best to make it with a sewing machine, and I feel like very few of you guys have those kind of tools too. So hopefully you can appreciate that I went there, I tried it, and now you can too. Typically, I would never attempt a leather bag straight up. There's a reason why designer leather bags cost so much. It's for the stitching and the detail, the structural integrity, the shape. Man, it's complicated. But because it's a bucket silhouette, I decided to give it a go. Anything more complicated than this, who knows, I might not have ever tried. Essentially for the leather material, I walked into the fabric store, looked for a leather that I liked. It comes on a big sheet. This is the roll that's still left over. I feel guilty. I'm for sure gonna try to make something else of it. But leather is so hard to work with that I think I need a break. It might be a while before you see this come in again. But yeah, as you can see, the leather has really nice crisscross design on it, makes it look really professional and clean. And for this bucket bag to have its shape, you need to get really stiff leather. You can't have that soft buttery stuff because then you're just going to have a saggy bag. And the whole reason why those Mansur Gavriel bags look so good is because they have some nice shape to them. It's a bucket, but it's actually a rectangular cut on the bottom, and that's what gives it its corners and its good look. When it comes to construction, I honestly stared at Pinterest photos and Google images forever until I figured out how it's put together, at least to the best of my knowledge. Essentially, the way this works is you make two halves that are, I guess, cup-shaped, and then you put them together and sew them along the spine seam. In the tutorial, I'll make each half and I'll sew them together, and that is the most brutal part because you need a proper leather machine to do that kind of stuff, and I did it all by hand. No amount of video production is going to make hand sewing leather any easier for you. Don't just watch this tutorial to get ready, prepare a lot of patience to get ready. I took a couple more photos with this bag. The link is in the description for the blog post that I put together. I hope you guys enjoy this tutorial. It's been super requested on Instagram. I made this bag so long ago, and yes, finally this tutorial is done. If you're ready to see the tutorial, let's go! We're going to start with two rectangular pieces of leather. I've included the full dimensions in the blog, but this is the shape you're going for. It's roughly rectangular, and it's got two slits in the bottom to make two squares and one trapezoid in between. The first step is we're going to take a pair of clips, fold in those square pieces, and clip them so that they're at 90 degrees. Then we're going to sew along those diagonal edges of the trapezoid. I switched in the zipper foot of the sewing machine just to make navigation a bit easier, and I went real slow because I didn't want the needle to snap in the leather. Once you have both sides sewn down, you can just cut off the excess of the bottom pieces using a pair of scissors. On the right side is what it looks like after they've been cut off. We're going to loosely sew the two sides together along the spine and put in the holes. Both are a bit complicated, so I'm going to start with talking about the holes. Here's a sample piece of leather where I traced out a hole about half an inch in diameter and then cut it out with an X-Acto knife. You need six, and you should check my blog if you want to know how far apart they should be spaced. The holes are going to need a leather drawstring, and you're going to need a leather strap cut out of the same material. We're going to add some detail embroidery to both of them and then attach them to the bag. The full dimensions for these are in the blog. The drawstring needs a straight stitch down the middle, and the strap needs a border stitch around the edge. The rest of the sewing for the straps and the bag is all done by hand. You keep it nice and neat on the outside, but use any crisscrossing you need on the inside. I use this small lid to push through the needle each time because using your fingers can make them pretty raw. All the hand stitching is the most tedious part of the whole process, so I advise putting on some show or YouTube to pass the time while you're sewing. And that is how I managed to make my own leather bucket bag. Financially, did cost less than a couple hundred you're gonna spend on the real deal. But time-wise, time is money. And it took me a lot of time. I just want you guys to know that because I don't want you to think naively that this is going to be an easy project. In concept, it's easy to put these pieces together. In practice, especially without leather tools like me, slow. Be careful, don't hurt yourself with the needles. Stabbing repeatedly through thick leather is not easy, so be patient. Again, if you want to see more photos of the bag, there's a link in the description with more photos for you. If you like this video, you support me bleeding in the fingers in order to make bags for you, please subscribe, please like the video. There'll be plenty more tutorials to come. And if you want to talk to me anytime, you can always reach out to me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. I am with Wendy. Oh, and on Snapchat too now. I'm with Wendy. Follow me on any of those and I hope you enjoy. Like this video, subscribe if you want to see more. I love you guys. Hope it's evident by my strugglings. I'll see you guys next week. Bye.